Hi everyone. So it is BOGO week. We have some amazing deals coming out each day this week. I just wanted to come into your homes via this video and offer you a bit of a virtual hug and offer you a few different ways to be able to use your oils to support yourself through these trying times. A lot of us are doing it tough, and I completely understand if purchasing essential oils right at the moment is not on your top of the list of priorities right now. I get it. I just wanted to help to educate and give a few different ways for these oils to be able to support you this week. This is day one. BOGO box has been revealed. There's a beautiful, a very cute platypus warmie that you may be able to gift one of the kids to brighten their day through that, or you can keep it for yourself for comfort. The BOGO box has got lots of great emotional supporting oils, grounding oils, oils that are good for anxiety, depression, panic attacks, stress, pretty much everything you need as an emotional toolbox, plus a few other oils that are specifically supportive for the immune system. So that is a hot topic right now with everything that's going on. So it is really vitally important to support your immune system in a prophylactic, which is a preventative way, and also to support yourself if you do get sick and to know exactly how to do that. Mental health comes from having good daily practices in place. So I'm gonna go through a few different little ways to use the three oils that are on offer today. Specifically the frankincense, the laurel leaf, and the Litsia. So frankincense is the king of oils. It is incredibly grounding. It is incredibly anti-cancer, anti-tumor, great for cellular support and all, and pretty much, you know, when in doubt, get Frankie out, that's what we say. So frankincense is an oil that you can use in times of grief, in times of, in troubled times. In times when you feel like you are really stressed out. I use it every morning on the roof of my mouth. So I'm just gonna, this is not frankincense, but I'll just use a bottle to show you. So I take the lid off, I put my thumb on top, tip it upside down like that, and then put my thumb firmly, not too hard, but firmly on the roof of my mouth for 30 seconds. That transports the frankincense drop from your thumb onto the roof of your mouth. In that palate area, you have a kinesiology point for relaxation. And that is part of the reason why a lot of babies will suck their thumbs or feel comfort on a mother's boob or on a bottle and do that for comfort, dummies, those types of things, because it's pressing on that palate there, which is that reflexology point for, reflexology point for relaxation. So you can just press your thumb there without frankincense for 30 seconds, and it will help to just reset your nervous system. It brings you out of that fight and flight and into the rest and digest nervous system. So it brings you back into a parasympathetic nervous system state where you can digest your food well, your stomach's not in knots, you feel more grounded and calm. It's not an instant relief, but you will feel over the next few minutes and next half an hour to an hour, just a better sense of calm, feeling rational, like you can handle the day, and be able to put one foot in front of the other and make rational, cognitive, you know, good decisions and make a better plan for the day. And that's really important right now. We can feel really frazzled. We can feel like, you know, our life is a bit of a cobweb of, you know, this and that, and feel like you can't sort of finish a job and you're all over the place, scatterbrained. But the frankincense helps to just smooth all that out and helps you to feel really grounded. So the frankincense, really important right now. Taking a drop under your tongue each day, even if you don't feel like that and you feel like you've got it all together emotionally and mentally, frankincense, a drop under the tongue, is excellent for cellular support. So I recommend taking frankincense internally. You can also use it as a base note in a lot of your diffuser blends. So pairing it with things like lavender, frankincense, and wild orange. That's Vanessa Jean, our doTERRA grandmother of our team. She had her signature blend. It's a beautiful blend for nighttime or throughout the day. Frankincense is a beautiful oil that you can pair with just about anything, but it pairs beautifully with other floral oils, wood oils, and citrus oils. So whatever you've got in there, it will go really nicely with. So if I was doing a blend in the diffuser of, say, that frankincense, lavender, and wild orange, I would put one or two drops of frankincense and then one or two drops of the other two oils as well. If I was wanting it to be a bit more floral or a bit more citrus, I might do one drop of frankincense and then two drops of lavender and two of wild orange. So just have a play around with it. Blending oils is, it purely comes down to knowing what you want to use it for and then pair that with your own enjoyment, how you enjoy the oils. Some people might like it more floral, some people might like it more citrus. So you just will need to play around with it a little bit and use your own intuition. Litsea is a good replacement for On Guard. So if you've run out of On Guard, you can use Litsea instead. So it's great for antibacterial, antimicrobial, antifungal, antiseptic. You can use Litsea topically and aromatically. Litsea is great in the diffuser. It smells a little bit like lemon myrtle or lemongrass. So it's got a really nice stimulating smell and aroma. Litsea and frankincense you can pair together in the diffuser if you want a really nice, fresh, uplifting essential oil diffuser blend that will help to purify the air and kill airborne pathogens and those types of things. So Litsea can be used as a surface spray. You can use it as a room mist. You can use it in your perfumes and things like that. So it's got lots of those good cleansing and purifying and detoxifying qualities. Laurel leaf is the other oil that you get for free today. Laurel leaf cannot be purchased individually. It is one of the main ingredients in your Easy Air blend. So laurel leaf, it smells a lot like, you know, it smells pretty much exactly like, do you remember those eucalyptus ball lollies that we used to get in the canteen when kids? So it's pretty much smells exactly like a eucalyptus lolly. So it's got a really, really nice, fresh aroma. It's great to use it in the shower. I put a couple of drops just on the niche in the shower, and with the steam of the shower, it helps to bring that into the air, and it's great for supporting your respiratory system, easing your airflow and helping you to take deep breaths so that you can then feel relaxed and feel energized and ready for the day. Your laurel leaf can also be used, you know, one drop on the pillow, under the pillow slip. It's quite relaxing. So you can even use that over nighttime just to help open up the airways and practice deep breathing and have a really nice restful sleep. So the combination of all three of those oils, frankincense, litsea, and laurel leaf, can actually be used together in a diffuser blend that would promote grounding and relaxation, killing airborne pathogens and purifying the air, and increasing airflow and oxygenation and respiratory support. So you could actually combine all three of those together. This video is getting a little bit long, so I'm going to cut it off there. I'll put a few more uses into the email, and feel free to post in our group, in our Facebook group. If you're not part of that, please join. It is Get Active Health Solutions Tribe. I'll put a link for the group into, which is our private group for our team only. So I'll put a link for that into the email as well. If you have any issues with ordering, please call me. I'll put my phone number in there as well. I have, just for mental health reasons, deleted my Instagram and Facebook apps off my phone, and I've turned off notifications as well. So I am contactable by my phone or text or messenger or email at the moment. So I've still got four ways to contact me and stay in touch if you need anything. All right. Hope you have a lovely day, and I will talk to you all again soon.